If there are some strum patterns that you hear in your head but we haven't hit on yet, you're probably going to find them out here. These are going to be syncopated 16th strum patterns that we're going to go over. And these are found in a lot of styles of music. You'll find them at a variety of tempos. And you want to make sure that you're constantly subdividing your right hand to the 16th. This is going to make a lot of sense when you do it. Every note that you play, every strum will be in the exact place where it feels and sounds natural, and nothing will sound forced. The hand needs to keep moving in an alternating pattern. So for these two examples here, we're going to grab a standard E chord shape. Second finger, fifth string, second fret, third finger right under it on the fourth string, and the first finger on the third string, first fret. So we'll have an E major chord. And if you want to start just practicing your 16ths, that would be great. And example one will be 1 E and 2 E and 3 E and a E, 1 E and 2 E and 3 E and a E. So hopefully you can hear as I brought the tempo up a little bit, you can hear how it might be applied to a song. Example two, we're going to do more syncopated strumming. This will be one.